Today, I have a classic combinatorial question for you guys. The question is, we would like to know in how many ways we can put 6 distinct balls into 3 identical boxes. Notice, I numbered the balls 1 to 6, they are all distinct, but for the boxes, I didn't put on any labels to show that they are all identical. And in fact, this is one of the famous questions from the 12 ways from combinatorics. If you guys want to know more about such problem, you can go look that up. And in fact, Mr. Lee from Taiwan, he asked me this question when I was in Taiwan this summer. At the time, I couldn't solve it. I was just trying to break down into cases the slowest way possible. He had a very nice way. We filmed a video. If you want to check that out, the link will be in the description. Today, I'm actually going to demonstrate one of the fewer solutions for this problem, which I think is so nice. You really have to see this. Here we go. The reason that this is a hard question is because the boxes are identical. Because if you put all 6 balls into this box, it's the same as if you put all these balls into this box. Because the balls are indistinguishable, so it doesn't matter where you put all 6 balls. So it gets really tricky, but it's okay, because let's take a look at the easier case. The easier case is if we have 6 distinct balls, and then suppose we have 3 distinct boxes. And because now the boxes are different, I'm just going to put 1, 2, 3 right here, and I'm going to give them names A, B, and C. Now, if I put all 6 balls into box A, this will be different than if I put all 6 balls into box B. Alright, so that's a major difference between identical boxes versus distinct boxes. So now, this is how you can do it. Starting with ball 1, ask yourself, how many ways you can put ball 1 into this box? Well, you can put into box A, B, or C, so you have 3 choices. And here, we are not talking about any other extra conditions. So, just one ball, right, the first ball into these 3 boxes. Some box can be empty, right, things like that. Next, this ball. Again, you can go to box A, B, or C, so again, 3 choices. Likewise for the next one, likewise for the next one, likewise for the next one, likewise for the last one. All in all, 3 to the 6th power ways to do this. Again, this right here is so much easier because the boxes are distinct, or you can also say they are distinguishable. So, is it possible for us to somehow create cases so that we can treat this as distinct boxes? Yes, and this is the beauty of that solution. Check this out. So I'm going to write down 1. This is how you write 1 in Chinese, because I have used 1 and also A. So yeah. Anyways, here we go. You have 1, 2, 3. 3 identical boxes. Step 1. Let's put ball 1 into this box. Let's put ball 2 into this box. Now, we have these 3 boxes. Can we treat them as 3 distinct boxes? The answer is yes, because you can look at the first box as the box contains ball 1. This box is the box as the box contains ball 2. And this is the box that has no ball 1 and no ball 2. Now, we took care of 1 and 2 already, going to 3. How many ways can we put 3 into this box? Well, 3 can go here, that's one choice. Or it can go here, that's another choice, or it can go here by itself. That's the third choice. So, ball 3 has 3 choices to go, right? 3 different choices to go. Now the next one, 4, again, 1, 2, 3, so another 3 choices. Ball 5, 3, ball 6, 3. From here, we can talk about 3 to the 4th power. Now, case 2, here, 1, 2, 3 again. How can we have a systematical way to do something like this though? Well, this is the genius of that solution. Ready? I'm actually not going to put ball 3 right here. It's a 1, 2, 3, that's like, it's going to be some overcounting if we just put 1, 2, and 3. But instead, we are going to put ball 2 along with ball 1 into this box. Now, you can see this case and that case, they have to be different. Because for the first case, no matter how we count, whatever happened, ball 1 and ball 2, they were never in the same box. Now, they are in the same box, so this and that, they are totally different. Then, we can put ball 3 in here. Aha, the first box, second box, and the third box, once again, you can look at them very differently, right? Now, we just have to worry about ball 4, 5, and 6. For 4, you can put it along with 1 and 2, or go with 3, or go with the empty 1. So we have 3 choices. For 5, again, 1, 2, 3. And then for 6, 1, 2, 3. So 3 to the third power. Ah, this is what we need. This is what we need. Now, case number 3. That's how you write 3 in Chinese. And then we have 1, 2, 3. We'll do the same thing. Let's put 3 into here. So we have 1, 2, and 3. And then let me put 4 right here. And now we have to worry about 5. 5 can go to this one along with 1, 2, and 3, or it can go this one with 4, or go to this one by itself. So 3, and then take care of 6 now, 3 choices, so 3 to the second power. Now, 1 is like this, 2 is like this, 3 is like this. This is how you write 4 in Chinese. Yeah, anyways, 1, 2, 3, you know the pattern. Put 4 in there, so 1, 2, 3, 4, and then we had to worry about put 5 here, and now we just have to worry about ball number 6. Either go here, here, or here. So 3, and that is 3 to the first power. Now, be careful. Are we done? No. Put 5 in here, because if you look at all this right here, 1, 2, 3, 4, they were never the same box with 5. So now we have to put 5 in here, and this is how you write 5 in Chinese. So we have 1, 2, 3, and we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And in fact, now we have to worry about where to put 6. Either you put it here, and you're done. There's no more other balls, right? Or you can put it here. But remember, this box and that box are the same, so it doesn't matter. Let's say put the 6 here. So we just have one possibility, and that is 3 to the 0th power. Now, are we all done? No! We have one more case, because 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, they were never in the same box throughout these cases. So the last one is, we have no other balls. And in fact, if you put all 6 balls into this box, it's the same as this box or that box, because all the boxes are the same. So we will have to add one more right here. Right? So finally, we just have to add this, 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 and that together. And you can work that out. Perhaps I'll write down the answer right here for you guys. 81 plus 27 plus 9 plus 3 plus 1 plus 1. The final answer is 122. This right here is such a nice question and such a beautiful solution. And now, you might know what I'm going to ask you next. What if instead of 3 identical boxes, we have 4 right here? Go ahead and try to figure that out. And then at the end, of course, I want to thank the viewer for suggesting us. This solution is so wonderful, so nice. Thank you so much. That's it.